to our channel. My name is Claudia Soto. I'm a realtor out here in Southern California. And in today's video, we're gonna do a little vlog. So we're gonna take you guys out to the Menifee Town Center and kind of show you guys around. I know a lot of people that aren't from, you know, Menifee or the Temecula Valley area, they have a misconception that Temecula Valley or Menifee is kind of in the middle of nowhere. And if you haven't been here in the last 5 years, then you definitely have not seen all of the new developments in the area. So I wanted to take you guys along with me and kind of show you guys what we're going to be doing in the area, and that way you guys can kind of check out some cool little spots to get lunch and kind of see what the Menifee Town Center has to offer. We're also going to, well, right now I'm going to finish up some work and then probably take you guys with us to the office, just to show you guys around in Lake Elsinore. And then from there, we're gonna head out to the Menifee Town Center area because we have a closing. So we have to drop off a closing gift to our sellers. We sold their home in the village, or the villages in the Menifee Town Center. And so I wanna show you guys what that area looks like. It's right across the street from the Santa Rosa Academy. So really excited to show you guys and to film this little video, so follow us along. First things first, getting my coffee in. I get the iced triple espresso, and I get it with 3 pumps of the caramel brulee or creme brulee. It's one of those. And I just get the rest of it filled with the cold foam. It's delicious. If you like coffee, try it out. Let me know what your favorite Starbucks drink.
We are headed to Menifee now, so we're going from Lake Elsinore. We're passing the 15 freeway, and we have to go through the east side of Lake Elsinore. So we're going to pass the In-N-Out and all of the construction that's going on for the off-ramps. And these streets right here, this is Railroad Canyon. These are the only streets, really, that will take you to Menifee from this side of Lake Elsinore, or you can go through Scott Road. I will say that you can expect traffic around 5 p.m. in this area if you live up here in Canyon Hills and Canyon Lake. And then this is the new community Ridgeline. It's going to be in Westbridge. It's a gated community. If you guys want any more information on this community, reach out to me. The HOA will be about $208, and they are by appointment only. So reach out to me if you would like to go check out these homes. They don't have the models here physically. They have them on the west side of Lake Elsinore, but the homes will be built on this side. And so at that stoplight right there, passing the Bank of America, if you take that light and you make a right, it's going to take you to Canyon Lake Middle School and Cottonwood Elementary and Canyon Hills. And so we just kept going forward, and now we are passing Canyon Lake. Canyon Lake is a gated community, but it is also considered its own city. And so Canyon Lake is a unique master plan community, and it was developed in the 1960s. What's really cool about this community is that right across the street, you have a lot of shopping centers, and a lot of people use their golf carts to just go back and forth. Also, most people here have boats and water toys because there is a lake. That's why it's called Canyon Lake. I am going to speed up this clip just because I wanted to show you guys the road that takes you to Audie Murphy, which is kind of the start of Menifee. And I know that a lot of people watching this are from out of town. They're not local. So, you know, if you're from LA or San Diego or Orange County, kind of get an idea of how to get to Menifee. And so we're passing Audie Murphy Ranch, and all of the homes that you see on both the left and right side are Audie Murphy, and it's a huge master plan community. There are big public city parks, and then as well as some smaller parks that are spread all over the community in between the subdivisions. So I didn't want to bore you guys with the long drive. We passed a couple of gas stations and a couple of little shopping centers. And now we are passing the new Olive Garden, Sprouts, Wendy's. So this entire section is pretty new. I think they opened maybe a month or two ago. And so this is the Menifee Town Center that is under construction. If you guys like Dave's hot chicken, let me know. I just tried it out and it was really good. I like it more than Raising Cane's. I think it has more flavor. But let me know. Maybe it's just me. And so this is part of the Menifee Town Center. And you have a Krispy Kreme donuts, you have a couple of banks, and a lot of places to shop and eat. And if you would have just kept going forward another 2 minutes, you would have hit the 215 freeway.
So since we've been getting a lot of people interested in the Menifee new construction builds, here at the Menifee Town Center, there's this ramen spot that we really like. It's called Ramen Sushi.
It's all Tokyo House. Tokyo House ramen and sushi.
Something like that.
Yeah.
But within the same little shopping complex, there's a Yogurtland, a Habit Grill, Wingstop, Ono Hawaii Barbecue, and a bunch of shopping stores around here too.
Applebee's across the street. I'm kind of show you guys what it looks like.
All right, so we just finished up having a late lunch, and now we are going to Best Buy because we need to buy some office supplies and a printer and all of that fun stuff for business.
Right, guys, so now we're crossing the street on Han Street to go to the other side. That's called Countryside Marketplace. It's part of the Menifee Town Center, and they have a bunch more stores. So they have the Home Goods, TJ Maxx, Target, Best Buy over here, and a lot of little restaurants. So I'll flip it.
So as you guys can see, on this day, it was pretty busy because it was a Friday. So that's why there's a little bit more traffic than usual. The parking spots are a little bit more filled up than usual. And you have the Red Robin right here. You also have a BJ's restaurant, Chipotle on the other side, and there are a lot of places to just dine out over here. Also, the Home Goods, I think we just passed it, and I actually prefer this Home Goods a lot more than the Temecula one. I feel like it's a little less cluttered. I don't know if it's just because the holidays just passed and the Temecula one was just crazy, but I really like coming to the Menifee Town Center a lot more than the Temecula shopping stores. And so, yeah, as you guys can see, there's a lot to do around here. One thing that my clients are gonna miss about living 2 minutes from here is, oh, there goes a Panera, is that they are gonna be now like 15 minutes away from here. And right now, they're literally across the street. So whenever they need anything, it's, I'll be back in 5 minutes kind of a thing. But now they're gonna be living a little further. And they're really sad about that. And here we have some charging stations for Teslas right next to Lowe's. And my clients that sold at the Villages actually ended up buying a new construction home over at Seasons Elevated in the Breverde community of Menifee. So if you guys want to check those out, I have a video on that as well.
So we are here. We just closed on this home right here in the city of Menifee. It's a 3-bedroom, 2.5 bath. And right across the street, right there, is the Santa Rosa Plateau. No, sorry. That's in Waldemar. Santa Rosa Academy. Even though this is, I don't know if you guys can see over there, that's where the town center is at. Even though it's right next to it, these homes are so calm. I love it here.
and it closed over list price of $510.
We actually have a great story about this home. So we bought this home as we were newlyweds, essentially a very early investment in our marriage. We were very scared because it was a very big purchase, the biggest purchase of our lives. And turns out this was one of the best choices we ever made financially for us. First house we ever bought, first house we ever sold. And again, Claudia made that process so easy. So we're just so thankful for Claudia and everything she did for us.